boy, the reviews come out a lot faster when the critics go home at intermission. By the end of Funny Boy, Max Bialystock's hopeless musical of Hamlet, everybody's dead. And they were the lucky ones. And that's the best review we got. Where did I go wrong? What happened to me? What happened to me? You're looking at the man. You're looking at the man who once held the biggest name on Broadway, Max Bialystock.
13 letters.
I used to be the king. The king of all of Broadway. The best of everything was mine to have each day. I always had the biggest hits, the biggest bathrooms at the Ritz. My showgirls had the biggest hits. I never was the biggest. My praises they would sing.
A Ziegfeld!
So they'd say. My shows were always filled with glass. The best champagne would fill my glass. My lap was filled with gorgeous ass. You couldn't call me fat. There was a time when I was young and gay, but straight. There was a time when I was old. There was a time when each and every thing I touched would turn to
thank you.
You'll see my name in lights again. I'll adore Dr. Bright's again. My spirit's highest height again. I'll never suffer slight again. I'll taste so sweet delight again. No better, no more bite, no more bust, no more bite.
Just like you told me, to the title of the play, Cash.
So is the Iceman cometh. Thursday. I'll see you Thursday. Ta-ta, my little pouter pizza.
Oh, ta-ta!
Ta-ta!
Dirty old buzzard.
Can I come out of the bathroom now, Mr. Greenhouse Dog?
Yeah, sure. You come on.
I'm terribly sorry I caught you feeling up the old lady.
Feeling up the old lady. Thank you, Mr. Tact. May I take your coat?
Oh, thanks.
So, you're an accountant, huh?
Yes, sir, I am, sir.
Well then, account for yourself.
What?
Do you believe in God? Do you believe in gold? Look at that little old lady's skirts, huh? Bit of a pervert, are you? I know what you're thinking. How dare you condemn me without knowing all the facts?
Oh, now, Mr. Bielsa, I'm condemning you.
Having a rhetorical conversation. You know who I used to be?
Well, yeah, you're Max Bialystock, the King of Broadway?
No, I'm Max. That's right. That's right.
And may I say, Mr. Bialystock, but you're not just a dirty old man.
Thank you.
But you're also a great Broadway producer. And there's a little something about me that you should know. When I was a kid, I had the great fortune to be taken to Bialyhoo's of 1942. Look, I still have the ticket stub. And ever since, I've had this secret desire to be a Broadway...
Broadway producer.
Yes, sir.
Secret desire, huh?
Yes, sir.
Can I give you some advice, Kate?
Mm-hmm.
Keep it a secret. In the box.
Yes, sir.
Boy, will you look at that. There's a gorgeous blonde getting out of a Rolls Royce limo right now. That's it, baby. If you got it, flaunt it. Flaunt it.
Mr. Bialystock.
Yeah,
kid. Can I speak to you for a minute?
A minute?
Yep, just a minute.
All right, you got a minute. Go ahead.
Okay, well...
58 seconds, you wasted 2 seconds.
Oh, okay. In glancing at your books, here I noticed that there's a discrepancy between these two figures.
Kid,
now, I can't quite seem to make the figures...
28 seconds!
If I should just have a little bit of a moment of your time, we could talk
seconds.
Through this together, and but please, Mr. Bialystock, I can't function under these conditions. You're making me extremely nervous.
What do we got there? Is that a handkerchief or something?
Oh, this?
Yeah.
Oh, this is nothing.
Okay.
This is nothing.
Well,
this
nothing
is
nothing.
No!
Chemistry.
Oh, my blanket! My blanket! My blue blanket! Give me back my blue blanket! Give me back! I'm sorry. It's just I don't like it when people touch my blue blanket. It's on part. It's nothing. It's nothing. It's just I've had it ever since I was a baby, and I just. Oh, I find it very comforting. I think I need to lie down for a minute.
How do you find me? They all come here. I don't understand. What?
You're gonna jump on me.
No, not. No.
You're gonna jump on me.
I'm not gonna jump on you.
Smiling at it.
You know what they say, smile and the world smiles back at you.
This man needs a straitjacket. Feeling better?
Yeah. Yeah, I think I've come out of it now.
That's good.
May I speak to you for a moment?
Sure, Prince Mishkin. What can I do for you?
Okay, this is hardly the time for levity, Mr. Bialystock. I've found a serious error in the account for your last show, Funny Boy.
Wait, what?
Well, looks here that, according to your backers list, you raised $100,000. But your show only cost $98,000, so therefore, there's $2,000 left unaccounted for.
So I went to a Turkish bath, who cares? Bloom, do me a favor, would you? That show was a flop. You're an accountant. Move a few decimal points around. You can do it. You're part of a very noble profession. The word count is in your title.
That's cheating.
Gee, it's not cheating, it's charity. See this stick, Pinblum? Used to have a pearl in it the size of your eye. I used to have brand new shoes, $500 Italian suits. Look at me now, I got nothing. Come on, you can't send me to prison, please. Please don't you help me out. Help me out.
All right, I'll do it. Yeah, I'll do it.
Good.
$2,000 isn't that much. I'm sure I can hide it somewhere. And after all, the IRS, they're not interested in a show that flopped.
You got it all figured out, kid. Way to go. Well, I'm just going to have a little rest here. Don't wake me up, unless, of course, if it's yank me, spank me.
Hey, if we just add up these deductions here, here we get, amazing. Well, it's absolutely amazing. But under the right circumstances, a producer could make more money with a flop than he could with a hit. Yeah, it's quite possible. But if you were certain the show would fail, a man could make a fortune.
Yes?
Yes what?
Yes, you were saying. Keep talking.
Well, what was I saying?
You were saying that under the right circumstances, a man could make more money with a flop than he could with a hit.
Well, yeah, it's possible.
You keep saying